It's hard to think of human beings as primitive creatures when so many traits separate us from the rest of the animal kingdom. We're the only species to maintain a completely upright posture, for example, even amongst other primates. We boast a unique dexterity with our hands and increased brain volume and intelligence, too. It all allows us to distinguish ourselves via the use of speech, the development of tools, the use of fire, and so on, to grow to where we are today. Large, mass civilizations spanning every corner of the globe. However, humankind hasn't always been quite so unique and complex. In fact, in a time not too long ago, relative to the age of the universe, our human ancestors had more in common with modern squirrels than with modern people. So how did a small, rodent-like tree climber evolve into the dominating species of today? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, how was the first human born?
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more fascinating content?
The story of human evolution begins with the extinction of the dinosaurs. When an asteroid struck land 66 million years ago, as per the most commonly held theory, it may have rained death down upon the dinosaurs, but it also allowed a new class of animals to rise out of their shadowed holes. With most of the world's biggest creatures gone, and around 75% of Earth's total flora and fauna at the time by most counts, whole ecosystems collapsed, and the food chain was thrown into turmoil. But the catastrophe left massive, empty niches and key environmental roles just waiting to be filled. And so it was the mammals that rose to become the dominating class. And because there were so many positions to fill, a rich and diverse evolutionary boom occurred across a relatively short period of time. Within the next 10 million years, it's thought that between 3 and 5,000 species of mammals emerged on planet Earth, including the earliest classes of whales, bats, rodents, and, crucially for the human story, monkey-like primates, our earliest ancestors. These prehistoric primates then went through many changes very quickly, with the first significant development happening around 60 million years ago when the evolutionary line divided into strepsirrhines, also called the wet-nosed primates, and haplorrhines, the dry-nosed primates. This was a key moment in the slow progression toward Homo sapiens, as while the strepsirrhines remained primarily nocturnal and reliant on their sense of smell, the diurnal haplorrhines developed larger brains and were therefore able to rely on their vision, thereby already showing two more human-like attributes. From there, the haplorrhines continued to diverge for millions of years, with several of our primate cousins branching off the family tree. However, it wasn't until about 20 million years ago that another major development took place, the arrival of the first ape, known as proconsul. While still quite monkey-like in behavior, the earliest apes began taking on physical attributes that were, again, increasingly human in today's eyes. Importantly, they were significantly larger than their ancestors, weighing up to 110 pounds, while they notably lacked a tail. Still millions of years ago, and the apes continued their variation, branching into the great apes and lesser apes, and gradually giving birth to some of our other evolutionary cousins, such as gibbons, orangutans, and gorillas, all of which developed before the earliest humans came to be. As for our closest cousins, the chimpanzees and bonobos, they arrived much later, around 7 million years ago only. But what of the human ancestral branch itself? One of the first big steps in our transcendence from ape to human came with the evolution of the Ardipithecus, the first genuinely bipedal genus. Despite remaining a primarily tree-climbing species, with opposable big toes, small cutting teeth, and a brain size very similar to an ape, the Ardipithecus developed the breakthrough ability to walk on two legs. From here, it took massive strides through the evolutionary timetable, and within about 2 million years, that's now around 4 million years ago, the first Australopithecus evolved. Australopithecus retained ape-like features, including long arms and short legs, but they were becoming significantly more human still, largely thanks to one change. The opposable big toes present in earlier species had now moved to face forward on their feet. This meant they became more adjusted to walking reliably, which freed their hands for the earliest known use of stone tools. The Australopithecus thrived until around 2 million years ago, when evolution evolved along two more distinct directions. While one group is said to have developed stronger jaws to better help them eat the nuts and vegetation specifically available at the time, another evolved with weaker jaws but with larger brains. While both branches survived for a significant period, those with the larger brain proved to be more adaptable in the long run. And they ultimately gave rise to the genus Homo, taken from the Latin for man. And here is where human history is said to truly begin. The first member of the Homo genus was Homo habilis. Colloquially known as handyman, the progression of habilis is most notable for its ever-widening use of tools, which again led to many major evolutionary advancements happening quickly. In fact, within just 500,000 years, so now we're about 1.9 million years ago, Homo habilis had given rise to another new classification, Homo erectus, to make possibly the most crucial evolutionary leap toward modern man. Homo erectus was the first to closely resemble the proportions of a current human body. They had relatively elongated legs and shorter arms compared to the size of their torso, which was the result of their being fully adapted to living on the ground rather than in trees. Homo erectus had a slightly larger brain size too, although it was still only about 60% of the size of a modern human's. And they were the first to use fire as a tool. This, along with their bipedalism, enabled them to migrate outside of Africa to become the first group to be widespread across Europe, Asia, and Africa. Finally, according to fossil evidence, Homo erectus not only gathered in social groups, but they actually cared for their old and weak, something that was virtually unheard of until this point. It's believed that they had empathy and were emotionally developed as well as physically, something which allowed them to survive and even eventually thrive alongside modern humans before going extinct just 110,000 years ago. Over the period between 1.9 million years ago and 100,000 years ago, and as a result of Homo erectus's migratory patterns, new members of the Homo genus began springing up all across the world map. As each new species evolved to adapt to different environments, these various human groups began to diverge and cross over at various historical points, causing an intricate web of evolutionary lines. This has made it difficult to precisely know from which line after Homo erectus we, modern humans, find our origins. We may have evolved directly from Homo erectus or from one of the several species that branched off before or after it. Nevertheless, we do know that we were neither the first nor the last species to evolve along our branch. It's just that we're the ones that remain today. First appearing around 300,000 years ago, Homo sapiens are and were distinguishable from other Homo groups, most significantly by their having much larger brains, an adapted skull shape to house those larger brains, and a lighter skeletal frame. As a result, ancient Homo sapiens go down as being an exceptionally innovative group, developing advanced tools like fishhooks for hunting, bows, arrows, and spears also for hunting, sewing needles for clothing, and various building materials and methods for shelter. This ensured that sapiens would outlast all other Homo types, with the last Neanderthals, for example, dying out about 40,000 years ago. But while that's the human story so far, evolution is far from being done. And as much as we tend to assume that we're the ultimate end-of-the-line model, it will actually continue to alter us well into the future. In the past 100,000 years, for example, the average height of Homo sapiens is thought to have shrunk slightly, although we do appear to have grown slightly taller in the past couple of centuries. Meanwhile, although brains have been getting progressively larger throughout evolution up until this point, ours have actually decreased in size over the past 30,000 years or so, with it commonly said that a modern human has lost about a tennis ball's worth of brain size compared to earlier sapiens. Luckily for us, we remain a reasonably intelligent species, but who's to say what could happen in the future? For now, that's how the first human was born.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.